I don't know that I'll ever be able to proclaim the gospel again after that. Wow. Wow. Thank you so much. In my experience, in my few years as deacon, I was ordained in 2005, so it'll be at 13 years. I think this weekend, the fourth Sunday of Advent, is the hardest weekend to preach. Here's why. Let's be honest, folks. Even though we are still in this beautiful season of calm and quiet and joyful anticipation, the truth is so many of us are distracted. Right now, I'll bet somebody here is thinking, wait a minute, there's that Christmas card I didn't send to Uncle Harry. Or did I get that coworker or my boss or a friend the very perfect gift? Or are the children this Christmas morning going to be joyful? Because of that, the reality of this weekend closest to Christmas, I've heard that what's most important is that the homilist should get the attention of the assembly. So I've learned a little technique that I'm sure is going to get your attention. I can say it in one word. It's children. Children, come. I invite all the children here present from kindergarten through fifth grade to come join me. I took a bath, don't worry. Come forward. I'd like you to help me. You're only going to be here for a short time. Come on, don't be shy. When a few come, more will come. I don't see too many here. Here comes some more there. Good, good, come. Children, have a seat. Make yourself comfortable right there on the steps. Okay. So I'm going to ask you a question. Did you hear Father Ken at the beginning of Mass introduce himself? I have a question for you. Who am I?
Deacon.
Deacon? Deacon what? I get the same response when I ask the question at staff meeting. I'm Deacon Sandy, and here's a question I know you don't know the answer to, and that's okay. What's my last name?
Sandy.
My first name is Sandy. Actually, Deacon is my title. Sandy is my first name. What's my last name? Claus. I'm Sandy Claus. So you better watch out. I got a list and I'm checking it twice. I have another question for you, and this is where you can really help me. What do you do when you're happy? Wait, before you answer, let me ask it again. What do you do when you're really happy? Do you laugh, maybe?
Yeah.
Scream. Shout out might be a better way to put it, right? Anything else you can think of you do when you're happy? Did you ever do this? Leap for joy? No. Try it sometime. Here's why I ask. Let me remind you what we just heard in the gospel, so beautifully sung by our cantors. We heard that when Mary, there's our Mary statue. If you've never visited, go, it's beautiful. Say a little prayer there to Mary, perhaps a Hail Mary. Today we heard in the gospel that Mary, when Jesus was still in her womb, Mary traveled to a relative's house, and the relative's name was Elizabeth. And Elizabeth, you're smiling. Is your name Elizabeth? You think so, maybe. Okay. She likes the name. Elizabeth had a baby in her womb, too. It was John the Baptist. And here's what happened. When Elizabeth saw it was Mary, the baby in Elizabeth's womb, John the Baptist, leaped for joy. The baby, how can that happen? How can a baby in the womb know when somebody comes? God had something to do with that. But John the Baptist in Elizabeth's womb was so happy that he leaped for joy. Why do you think John the Baptist leaped for joy? It's a one-word answer, And it happens in 2 days.
Christmas.
Because John the Baptist knew that Christmas was coming, the very first Christmas. Through his mom, Elizabeth, John the Baptist knew that Christ was present, and that made him so happy that he leaped for joy. Now, I see out here your parents and some other adults as well, maybe your brothers and sisters. Do you know right now that Christ is present here in this worship space? Christ is present in the Blessed Sacrament Chapel. Christ is present in that ambo, that's what we call that, the Word of God. Christ is present in the Word. Christ will be present there when Father Ken does the consecration. Christ is present in Father Ken and our acolyte, and in our cantors and musicians, in our ushers, in our greeters, in our proclaimers, and in all the people here. Scripture tells us that we're a temple because the Spirit is in us, God is in us, Jesus is in us. Now, the reason I said that is to remind your parents that Christ is present, but you know what? I watched them when they came in, and I didn't see one of them leap for joy when they came in here. But Christ is here. So, I'm going to ask you to stand. I'm going to ask you to come out here so nobody gets hurt. And I'm going to ask you to join me as we show your parents what I wish for them on Christmas morning, okay? Here's what I wish. I wish, parents and my friends, brothers and sisters, I wish this Christmas morning that you awake and are so filled with the joy of children on Christmas that you're so filled with the awareness of Christ's presence coming again to us on Christmas Day that at least in your heart, you leap for joy. So let's show them how to do that, all right? On the count of three, we're all going to leap for joy and we're going to shout out Christmas. Are you ready? We can do it. Do it with me, okay? I'm going to turn around. We're going to count to three and then we're going to leap and we're going to shout Christmas. One, two, three, Christmas! Well done. Thank you. Thank you. My second closing is this. It's a gift. That's the end of my homily. Maybe the shortest one I've ever given. But I think you get it, don't you? Let's be filled with childlike joy because Christ is with us, in us, all around us, in our children, in creation, in everything. We should really know it when we come in here. So let's take that awareness of Christ present in here, the Christ being present out there.